up, guys? Welcome to Just Vibey Vibes. So today we're doing a third movie review today. Not that, we last and fifth, but we're doing two movies again. So this time we're doing, and the review is for the Netflix movie, the Nollywood movie that is on Netflix. It's called Who is the Boss? it was a good movie, but kind of I wanted to slap the girl a lot of times. Slap sense, you know, like when someone is self-sabotaging themselves and you want to like give them bah, to reset their brain to factory settings so that maybe they will not self-sabotage themselves. I want to slap a lot of times in the movie, but oh well. I guess that's some people's reality. Then we're also going to talk about a YouTube Nollywood movie, that a movie where I can actually put the link in the description like I always do. It's called Tangled Love. The love is tangled. I like it because it talked about mental health. So I like anytime we talk about mental health, we don't talk about that a lot enough, you know. There's one movie also on Netflix. What was the name of the movie? It's a Kenyan movie that had a Ghanaian actor that also acts Nollywood movie. They talked about dyslexia there. I'm trying to think what the name of that movie was. If I remember, I'll put the movie there. You should watch it. It's also good. I'm not going to review it like in details, but you can just put, you can, I'll put the name of the movie there. So if you have Netflix, watch it. It's also a good movie. I always like it whenever our movies talk about, you know, mental health is really important. Okay, so now let's go to the movie, Who is the Boss? So this movie, Who is the Boss, is like a young girl that is that works in advertising. She is an assistant to something to one of the top advertisers, the senior, whatever they want to call them there. And she's the one that comes up with all the ideas, and the woman still treats her like nothing. You know what I mean? Like, treats her really bad. Just like the way most senior, she's not like her employer, but most senior staffs treat their junior staffs in this thing. But then she's due for, there's a promotion that was coming up and she wanted the promotion. The man told her that she's not yet, you know, the promotion, she's in 2 years, like how many more years before she can even get that promotion. And then the boss, which is the boss of her own boss, was saying that they should promote the girl, and the woman is like, no, we shouldn't promote this. So what if she goes to another company? It's like, no, give her some other years first before. So she did it. The boss was actually trying to stunt her growth in the company. And she heard this. So then she was in the toilet crying. And then her friend is very rich, right? The family is very rich. And she's living in her friend's house. The friend is very rich. She's trying to pay the rent. The friend's like, no. The friend, she took the check. She's like, I'm not cashing it. So you know what I mean? So she has this support system around her. But still, the friend is like, okay, quit your job. She's like, I'm not quitting. She's like, what would I do? But she's like, I'm not quitting. You're not taking care of me. I'm not quitting. So then she continued in the job, but then they went to a friend's birthday party was coming up, and her friend had this friend that has money, but then he does acting like a theater. He actually literally bought a theater where he does his plays at. So yeah, because he has money, doesn't know what to do with the money, so that's what he does. So anyway, so she went to So he called her that he's supposed to come to a party. So he called her, she's like, where are you? You're not at my party, I can't see you. He's like, I'm at your party. I'm throwing you a party. So then she went to the party. Party looked like kind of like a place for an orgy. And then she went upstairs. And while she went upstairs, she was not talking to this guy. I think they need someone to do advertisement. And she said, oh, my friend is an advertiser. She has a company. And then she introduced her to the guy and everything. So the guy was like, okay, come and pitch your idea. So then they exchange numbers. Now go and pitch idea. The friend is like, no, you're not telling your boss about it. You go and pitch the idea yourself. As she said, but I don't have a company. So I will have a guy that registered the company in 2 days. So they registered the company. She went to pitch the idea. They like the idea, but they say, okay, the boss needs to meet her boss. So she say, I am the boss or the owner of the company. No, she now told them that, okay, yes, we'll meet him. So then now, who is the him? So they now had to find the friend's friend, the one that does the him. And the acting, this thing. So for him to do it, he didn't want to do it, but he said, okay, just for once, right? Yes. So he met the boss. They did this, so they got the job. But instead of her to quit her job and focus on her company, she still did not. She didn't quit her job. So that's why I wanted to slap her. So many times she could have quit her job, she didn't. So then now another company called her, but they cannot go, so because she doesn't want to compete with her company. So she now look for the company that her company is not competing with, to get to go to them for advertising. And then she kept on, so they were doing well, and now most company now wanted them. So when she gave an idea to her company, the boss says no to the idea because she has good idea. The boss says no, the idea is not good. Then she gave it to her company. Aniya was her name, the name of her company, and then her company would do it, and her company would they would choose that company instead of that because their ideas was really really good. But then she's gotten 3 jobs, quit the job. No, she still did not want to quit the job. Then the day now where there's this big company that they wanted her, they've already called that company, said no, they're not going with them, they want the other company. And then her boss is like, okay, the boss called her in the middle of the night, like, come to the office, we need to find idea for this company, right? I mean, for like our the advertisement, we need to give them the ideas we need to put together has to be better than anything so we can destroy the other company. And then she's like, oh no, I can't do it because I am that company. So see, you cannot quit your job. A lot of times you cannot. Now they think that guy is the CEO, they know he has money, they think he's the CEO of the company. You cannot just quit your job and focus on that one. No, now you have to open your mouth and tell your boss that you're the owner of the company while you're still working under them. You forgot that you signed contracts. Dumb. Like, I wanted to smack her. Then that's that. Then she came back home and then she cried and cried and cried. I don't understand. She was just like a self-sabotager. I know that some people are like that. So I was really pissed with her in the movie. The movie is interesting, but I was just like, what's wrong with this girl? Or to the movie, but I understand that some people are afraid of their own success. She's someone that is afraid of her success. Like, it's like she has told herself that she's not going to be successful, that she doesn't even want to try for her to be successful. So that was really like, what is happening? So anyway, so then they said they were going to do a lawsuit against her. The guy was telling her that there's no lawsuit, there's nothing that they can do. But then they didn't go for they had an appointment, you know, like, what do you call that? A presentation they were supposed to do, so they didn't go for that because they say if you go there, then we're going to sue you. So she left, and that was that. It was just like, I'm telling you, she was like, I felt like slapping her a lot, like just waking her up, you know, or shaking her, like, wake up, wake up. I felt like shaking her a lot throughout the whole movie because it was just like, seriously, girl, seriously, wake up. But she didn't. So then so she now started working. So they bought the company from her. She sold the company for cheaper, like, no, not for cheaper, but she sold the company whereby the company would have, what the guy said, don't sell. The guy told her his own story of how he sold the company quite early for I think $15 million, and then the company now, so whoever sold it was now for how many billion. So like, he, you know, like, that was, you know, sometimes people will make you sell your company and then you sell it quite quick while your company is worth more or would be worth more and very soon. So all of that. But she still did sell it, and she wanted to, and that gave her and the senior, blah, blah, the position that woman used to have in her own company. So the company is now owned by her boss, her boss's boss, but then she has the same position like her boss. But what the man wanted was to make her, give her that position for both companies. So then when she found that out, she now went to her boss and said, this is what they said. The boss is like, yes, I know that that's what they're going to do. Say, but you know, then why did you fight so hard for me to come back? And she said, if someone is going to take my position, I wanted it to be someone that is worth it. So is that why you were fighting her? So now she now understands why the boss was being mean to her, because the boss thinks that she's going to take her job. And then she's like, I would rather really prefer to have worked with you. So then the day she won an award, a very big award, because she did advertisement for like Access Bank. So she won the award. It was a big award. And then, but at the award, then, okay, she and the guy broke off. First of all, she told him that she needed him. She was not second, but she needed him. Then he left because obviously it was too much reminding him of his own life. Then he came back to her, and she now said, oh, I didn't even say they were dating. What kind of review is this? I didn't even say that they said dating. Yes, it's fair in love, they said dating. So anyway, then she came back to him, and then he came back to her, but she said he should have stayed with her when she needed him. That is not, like, you know, it's not fair. Like, she still loved him, but she cannot go with him because she feels like he can just leave at any time. So that was it. So then that day after the hour, she's there crying. Then she went to his okay, then she's there crying. The lady came to her and said, if you're going to have my job, you cannot cry, blah blah, you cannot let them see you cry. And she's like, oh, the guy just told her then that she's fired, you know, the girl will be the one doing. And she's like, I would rather have worked with you. She said, really? So then they now went to the boss and said, her boss is starting a company and they are going to work together. So after the boss, like, the look on his face, he was like, I'll destroy. They say you cannot do nothing to us because, you know, and we will try not to destroy you. So then The boss was like, oh, she's like, oh, I'll do anything to just see the look. I'm happy that I helped you to get that look in his face. And then she's like, oh, so, but you're not going to work with me? She said, no, she's not working with me. What are you going to do? She said, she does not know. So now she said, doing what the guy was doing, not know, just living life. So then she now went to the guy's class where he does like the acting, you know, improv, where they would just be passing ball and then they'll just be acting something. Then she got the ball and then she tries to get to him and then blah, blah. At the end of the day, they get back together and then they kissed and that was the end of the movie. But I felt like the movie, I wanted to beat that a lot. Like, don't be that kind of person that you're like, you're self-sabotaging yourself. I know it's easy. We self-sabotage ourselves like literally too without even knowing, because we don't feel that we deserve something, or we don't feel that we are good enough to do something. Self-sabotaging is real, and I'm sure almost everybody, maybe most people do it sometimes. I'm sure I've done it sometimes to myself, which is not right. But we self-sabotage ourselves a lot. But how one is like, opportunities were just looking at her, like smacking her face, and she's like, no, I don't want to. No, I didn't understand that part. Like, the way rate at which she self-sabotaged herself, I didn't get it. Like, I don't understand that someone can do that to themselves. Like, you know, like, it was just annoying to me. Yeah, well, this is shit. Like, wake up. Yeah, so that was it. And then the other movie that I'm going to talk about, which is Tangled. Is it Tangled Love or Tangled? What did I say the movie name was again? God, have mercy on me. Look at me, I forgot the name of the movie that I want to talk about. Tangled Love. Yes, I was right. So yeah, Tangled Love. So the movie is really, really interesting. He talked about mental health, like I said. He had Stan and Zay needs and some other people. Okay, so it was a very interesting movie. This girl, she's 33 years old, so she's, you know, Nigerian. Yes, she's like 100 years old. So she's not married yet. And so then she met this guy. And then the guy liked her, and then they dated in 1 month. He asked her to marry him, and then she married him, and then everything was going well. But then she met someone on the road that was her relative, and then she hugged the person, and then he got angry, started fighting the guy, and then now he started thinking that she's cheating on him. He would beat her that she's cheating on him, like everybody's like, you know what I mean? Like he opened an agency for her, because she was modeling before, but she was now getting older and they did not want her anymore. So he opened a modeling agency for her, but he told her that she can only have female models, no male models, because he's very jealous. He will beat her because, you know, like, he's just like over jealous. That's the whole point. When I come to find out, his sister now came from America. He was in psychiatric hospital because he killed his first wife out of jealousy. He has this there's this mental health and this thing they called in the movie. There's a mental health this thing, issue that he has that makes him think that someone is an obsessive something. So it can come in so many ways, but for men mostly, or for people sometimes come in the form where they think that someone is cheating on them. So he can see things that is not happening. Like, he even got her a driver so that the driver can take note of everywhere she's going. She's standing there and talking to the driver. All he saw was the driver holding her bum. So that means he's seeing things that are not there, and then he beats the driver, and then beat her, almost even killed her that day. Not the sister that knocked on the door. He was going to kill her just exactly the same way he actually killed his first wife. That's how he was going to kill her. So then the sister was telling him, how come he's beating her, you're still there? She's like, because, you know, the love. And he really loved her too, but the behavior, God. I don't know how people stay in those kind of things anyway. But yeah, so the sister was like, why did she marry him 1 month? That one, I'm in disagreement with that. There are people that meet in less than 2 weeks, they marry. I don't think someone should, there's no time of courting, because they could have courted for 5 years and it could have still been like that later on. So there's no, maybe she would have seen, because that was meant that he would have started thinking that she's cheating on him, so maybe that would have happened. But at the end of the day, there's no right time to cut someone. I don't think there is. You can date someone for 1 month, 1 week, 2 weeks and marry, and then some people date someone for 10 years and they marry in less than 1 year, they're divorced. Why some people will be with someone, they meet someone for like 1 week and then they marry and they're together 30 years time and more going, and like forever. So I don't think there should be this on that, but the sister thought that, oh, she should not have. Why was she rushing? Blah, blah, blah. But anyway, long story short, then they got him to, she said she didn't want to leave him because she loved him and all that. So she still wanted to stay, but the sister said, okay, leave him for some time. I'll try and get him to meet the doctor and all that. And then, so then he got a doctor coming, you know, everything. He didn't want to go back to the psychiatric hospital, but they're going to come at home to meet him, and then with medication and all that. She was already pregnant, so now at the end, he was probably taking his medication and having everything that he needed. So he was with her. Now she understands his problem. So she makes sure no guy, you know, nothing around to even make that whole thing happen. And then they were happy with Masajid. Like, he was really a good lover, if not for only that whole part. So then they were happy together, and then they showed where she was about to give birth, so he was taken her to the hospital. So that was the end of the movie. It was really, really a good movie. I think you should watch it, because I'm happy when they talk about mental health or things like that in our movies, because in Africa, and mostly in Africa, there's this thing, or even black people in general, we don't, even black people in diaspora, there's this thing about mental health, but we don't take it seriously. So it was really good that they talked about that. So I really, really liked the movie. I think there's a lot of lessons in it, and I still think that if someone slap you, should leave them. So, well, that's my thoughts. But anyway, don't stay in abusive relationship, emotional, verbal, physical, psychological, mental, whatever one. Don't stay in abusive relationships. That's all I'm going to say. Say no to abuse. Okay, I hope you like the reviews of the this one, and Thank Good Love, and also the Who Is the Boss. Okay, I'll see you some other time. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Bye.